So Balenciaga is known for its edgy designs, the brand often pushing the envelope, but critics are accusing the brand now of crossing the line in this latest campaign.
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 23 worst marketing fails of each year. For this list, we'll be looking at a failed corporate branding, advertising, or promotional scheme from every year since 2000 until 2022. How many of these marketing campaigns do you remember? Let us know in the comments below. 2000, Nike's horror ad. The athletic apparel brand had a rough start to the new millennium thanks to one of their commercials getting bad reviews. It came out alongside two others starring athletes demonstrating game-changing physicality, accompanied by the slogan, "Why sport?" The contested ad featured professional runner Susie Favor Hamilton in a fictional situation reminiscent of classic horror films. Being chased by a masked man wielding a chainsaw, the Olympic athlete is shown easily outrunning her threatening pursuer. It was received poorly for a couple of reasons. First, some critics claimed it promoted misogynistic violence. Second, parents were upset when it ran on television during the Olympics, while kids were likely watching. The commercial was eventually taken off the air. 2001, Royal Mail logo change. The British Postal Service spent roughly £2 million on a brand makeover in 2001, changing everything, including its name. Unfortunately, people weren't fans.
I mean, Consignia is the most stupid name you've ever, in your whole life.
The new name, Consignia, was meant to show that the company wasn't just a postal service, but it came off as obscure and unexplanatory. And the new blue logo, full of colorful curves, looked nothing like the bold red rectangle people had come to associate with the post office group.
If you've got two of the best known brands in Britain, which I think Post Office is actually number one and Royal Mail is number three, why would you then want to invent something else that nobody understood?
The change was so unpopular, the Communication Workers Union wound up boycotting it. The reworked look and name didn't last long, and in 2002, the company returned to something more familiar. 2002, acclaimed speeding ticket coverage.
3, 2, 1, go!
The now bankrupt video game publisher pulled a few stunts in the name of marketing during its time, but this one takes the cake. For the promotion of Burnout 2 Point of Impact, the company practically incentivized people to engage in unsafe driving. Acclaim offered to refund any speeding tickets issued in the UK on the racing game's release day, a move that was condemned by the British government. A spokesperson for the Department of Transport said, "The promotion obviously encouraged people to break the law and do something dangerous." Thankfully, the company eventually rescinded the offer. 2003, Red Lobster's Crab Legs. In 2003, the restaurant chain ran an all-you-can-eat promotion, selling endless crabs for $22.99.
Bottomless buckets of meaty, succulent snow crab legs.
While the campaign was meant to boost the company's earnings, they ended up losing roughly $3.3 million in 3 months, plus $405.9 million in stock. Apparently, then-President Edna Morris had counted on patrons enjoying a second serving of shellfish, but not a third or fourth.
For the gentleman.
All you can eat! All you can eat!
All right, when you're ready, take this plate over.
Please, don't take the steam tray, sir!
She and the company parted ways soon after. Considering Morris's previous experience heading Quincy's Family Steakhouse, reports surmise that she didn't think about crab being less hearty than red meat. The rising cost of snow crab at the time didn't help matters either. 2004, Coke releases Dasani in the UK.
I don't know what the zoological term for is exactly, but a sip of this clear right up.
The launch of Coca-Cola's bottled water line in the UK started off rough when they used the word spunk in their branding. While the word implies pluckiness in the company's home country, America, to the Brits, it's slang for a certain sort of bodily fluid. People also criticized the product for being merely filtered tap water from Sidcup. Yet that ended up not even being the worst part of the whole ordeal. It soon came to light that there was something funky in the bottled water after all, Tests showed that the liquid contained alarming and illegal levels of a potentially cancer-causing agent called bromate. Dasani hasn't been reintegrated into the British market since. 2005, Snapple's failed attempt at breaking a Guinness World Record. What better way to advertise a product than by beating a Guinness World Record?
All-natural Snapple.
New Yorkers love it. You're gonna love it too.
Too bad Snapple's attempt at besting one ended up in a puddle. The drink brand tried to erect the world's largest popsicle in Union Square, but the 25-feet-long Snapsicle simply couldn't take the heat. A significant amount of it melted, resulting in gallons of liquid popsicle messily gushing out of the freezer truck and onto the New York City streets. Although part of the frozen treat still remained intact, it was no longer stable enough to stand up. What was left was taken away. 2006. All I want for Christmas is a PSP. If there was one word to describe this advertising stunt, it's cringe. In an effort to market PSPs to children, Sony hired a company called Zippitoni to create a fake amateur blog. It was made to look like it was run by two tween boys, Charlie and Jeremy, but it radiated Steve Buscemi on 30 Rock energy.
How do you do, fellow kids?
What?
A music video posted on the site was especially embarrassing. It shows an adult man rapping about his desire for a PSP and his plan to ask his parents for one.
Game's so crazy. They totally amaze me. Gotta ask my mom for one.
Consumers tend to not like stealth marketing, especially when it targets youth. Plus, the blog was just plain bad. 2007. LifeLock CEO shares social security number.
I'm here to prove just how safe your identity can be with LifeLock.
You would think the co-founder and CEO of an identity theft protection company would be careful with his own social security number. However, Todd Davis was anything but when he used his as part of an advertising scheme. Davis shared the numerical sequence in commercials, on billboards, and even plastered on the side of a truck.
Protect yourself, your family, and all you've worked for. Guarantee your good name now.
Predictably, things didn't end well. Although the campaign succeeded in getting everyone's attention, it backfired when people began using Davis's social security number. It was reported that by 2008, Davis's identity had been stolen 13 times. Besides being dumb, the campaign was also costly. Since the service failed to do what its advertising claimed, the Federal Trade Commission issued the company a $12 million fine in 2010. 2008, Snickers gets some nuts at. A series of commercials for the chocolate bar from 2008 leans into a pun regarding one of the candy's main ingredients. For the marketing campaign, the brand decided to reference another connotation for the word nuts, relating to a person's private parts. The commercials feature Mr. T, an actor known for his toughness, accosting men who are acting in a way he deems as unmanly.
Quit your jibber-jabber! You ain't hurt! You pathetic! If I ever catch you acting like a crazy fool again, you're gonna meet my friend Pain!
One advertisement in particular drew criticism for being homophobic. It shows a man who could be coded as gay being attacked by the B.A. Baracus actor while speedwalking.
It's time to run like a real man! Take that, speedwalker! Do it again, sucker! And there's gonna be trouble with the capital Mr. T!
It ends with Mr. T delivering a punny tagline to the audience. Upon receiving backlash, the Mars company pulled the short video from the air. 2009, illegal weapon from EA. One of the perks of being a game journalist is getting PR packages from video game companies. It's a win for both parties. The players get free stuff, and the brand gets free advertising. It's too bad the gifts sent out by EA to promote the Godfather 2 video game were banned in many states.
Anonymous game! Get these guys!
Good job.
While brass knuckles are certainly on theme for the action-adventure video game, the sentiment was that EA had no business distributing dangerous weapons. They resolved the matter by requesting recipients send the gifts back. This whole fiasco seems like it could have easily been avoided. But alas.
I warn you, I'm not gonna fight fair though. So I bought these.
2010. Spirit Airlines jokes about oil on beaches. The budget airline has a reputation for being problematic. So folks weren't that surprised when one of their marketing campaigns demonstrated poor taste.
Spirit Airlines is creating controversy again.
The company released a series of photos depicting women sunbathing on beaches, accompanied by the slogan, "Check out the oil on our beaches." What's the kicker? The ads were revealed in the middle of the Deepwater Horizon oil spill crisis. Today, the incident is considered one of history's largest environmental disasters. The fact that Spirit cracked a joke while it was still ongoing was widely seen as heartless. The company defended its ad, though, insisting that they weren't referencing the disaster through the use of tanning oil.
Even though spirits referring to tanning oil, people are still calling the campaign offensive and tasteless.
2011, Groupon Super Bowl ad. The discount e-commerce marketplace missed the mark with a series of commercials that aired during the 2011 Super Bowl. One in particular appears to trivialize the unrest in Tibet that lasted throughout the second half of the 20th century and into the 2010s. It shows actor Timothy Hutton addressing how Tibetan culture is being threatened before cheerfully discussing Tibetan cuisine.
But they still whip up an amazing fish curry.
It was accompanied by two other ads, which make light of animal endangerment and deforestation, respectively. While the company claimed these were all parodies, that wasn't made clear to the audience. Instead, the dramatic switches in tone and topic make all three seem insincere.
But not all deforestation is bad. And since 100 of us bought at Groupon.com, we're all saving 50% on a Brazilian wax at Completely Bare in New York City.
2012, Susan Boyle's hashtag party. Tagging a word or phrase using the hash symbol has become standard on the internet. On Twitter, hashtags are a handy tool for individual users, brands, and activist groups alike. While helpful for promotional purposes, they can also backfire. That's what happened in 2012 when Susan Boyle's team started one that was poorly written. It was supposed to promote Boyle's album party, celebrating her new release. While it gained a lot of attention, it probably wasn't for a reason that the singer wanted. Without any spaces or capitalized letters, the phrase had multiple interpretations, not all of which are safe for children.
Oh no! It reads Sue's anal bum party. A sus anal bum party!
The unfortunate combination of words had people thinking not about the artist's vocal ability, but rather her rear end.
Susan album party, so it looks like Sue's anal bum party.
2013, Hyundai's car safety ad.
The new iX35 from Hyundai.
The South Korean car company met backlash when they tried demonstrating the iX35's clean features in an advertisement released in 2013. The car model boasts of 100% water emissions thanks to its hydrogen fuel cell. With concerns about climate on the rise, a vehicle that runs on hydrogen should have been easy to market. However, the company seemingly felt the need to go for shock value with the commercial produced by its in-house agency. It depicts a man trying and failing to take his own life by carbon monoxide poisoning. The ad did not go over well for obvious reasons. In 2014, NYPD's photo campaign.
The NYPD set themselves up to be the hilarious butt of a joke.
In yet another incident surrounding failed hashtags, the NYPD opened themselves up to be embarrassed when they started one on Twitter. The department's official account called on people to share photos with city police officers using the hashtag MyNYPD tag. While they expected friendly images of citizens and officers standing side by side, what they got were pictures and videos showing officers in, shall we say, not the best light.
There were no hugs, there were batons being wielded at citizens.
Considering police brutality was and continues to be a concern among American citizens, it's not surprising that the NYPD hashtag got this kind of engagement. 2015. Bud Light's up for whatever slogan.
Bud Light is apologizing over a controversial marketing slogan.
Bud Light's questionable campaign got them in trouble a couple of times during 2015. It started in March when the beverage's official Twitter account made a post referencing an icky St. Patrick's Day tradition. The tweet encouraged people to pinch those who aren't hashtag up for whatever. They met backlash again in April when they started placing taglines on their drinks labels. One of the slogans read, "The perfect beer for removing no from your vocabulary for the night." Considering the dangers of irresponsible alcohol consumption and the importance of consent, the company should have been encouraging responsible behavior. Instead, they did this. At least they didn't reference a racist hate group in their marketing, unlike a Krispy Kreme promotion in the UK from the same year.
What happens when a business in the UK has a promotional event every Wednesday called KKK Wednesdays? Well, they get a little bit of heat for it.
2016, Chaobi washing detergent commercial. It's not difficult to see why this Chinese commercial drew criticism from viewers, as it leans into racist stereotypes regarding cleanliness. The short video depicts a black man in dirty clothing being shoved into a washing machine before emerging, now suddenly Asian. Despite its problematic premise, the advertisement reportedly ran for some time in China before going viral among English-speaking internet users. As Chaobi started to receive backlash from viewers in the West, they defended their commercial before later backtracking and expressing regret over the ordeal. Interestingly, the clip draws upon an Italian laundry detergent commercial from 2008. The original's premise is slightly different, but still super problematic. Looking bueno in them jeans and heels. Belly button showing, got some sex appeal. Streaks in your hair, fingernails did up. 2017, Live For Now Pepsi commercial. This misguided advertisement for Pepsi featuring Kendall Jenner only lasted a day before it was pulled by the company. Structured as a short film with lions by Skip Marley playing in the background, it's a shallow attempt at engaging with the Black Lives Matter movement and police brutality. It shows the model and a few token people of color joining a protest march with no clear cause. A standoff with the police comes to a resolution when Jenner gives one of them a Pepsi can. The other demonstrators celebrate the interaction like it's the end of racism. People were quick to point out how tone-deaf to the point of almost being humorous the ad is. Saturday Night Live even made it a sketch.
I gotta go, I'm on the set of my Pepsi commercial. I stopped the police from shooting black people by handing them a Pepsi. I know, it's cute, right?
2018, Heineken's Sometimes Lighter is Better ad. We're not sure how a commercial like this made it to air in 2018. The ad starts with a bartender noticing a fair-skinned woman across the way who's unhappy with her drink. He takes it upon himself to slide a light beer over to her. Along the way, it passes three black people before stopping next to the slogan, "Sometimes lighter is better." Yikes. Many were quick to wonder how nobody on the creative team flagged the racist implications here. The combined casting, editing, and tagline is not a good look. After facing backlash, the company axed the commercial, along with the rest in its series. 2019, North Face Wikipedia hack. The online self-proclaimed encyclopedia provides free information on a wide variety of topics. While teachers might not consider it scholarly, Wikipedia pages are usually one of, if not the first results in a web search. But back in 2019, the outdoor goods manufacturer North Face decided to take advantage of the nonprofit's popularity and public editing system. Instead of paying for advertising, they uploaded photos of their own products to the Wikipedia pages for multiple geographical landmarks. They even made a video about the endeavor. The Wikimedia Foundation condemned the company's actions. The North Face ended up issuing an apology. 2020, Burger King's Moldy Burger. In an effort to demonstrate the use of less artificial preservatives in their food, the fast food joint made a commercial that spoiled our appetite. It shows a time lapse of their Whopper hamburger over 34 days, growing progressively moldier and moldier.
What a difference a day made.
The high-quality video and close-up shot of the sandwich shows the decomposition in all its disgusting glory. We guess it's nice to know that Burger King is using more natural ingredients, but rotten meat simply isn't appetizing. Needless to say, we'll never look at a Whopper the same way again. 2021, American Airlines Rainbow Capitalism.
Throughout this past month, LGBTQ communities in the U.S. have been celebrating pride in cities and states around the country. Corporate America has made itself a part of that too.
June 2021, aka Pride Month, was the summer of major corporations using LGBTQIA+ supportive branding to make money. Despite the seemingly inclusive marketing, many companies were criticized for being hypocritical and performative. American Airlines was one of the biggest offenders. Although they switched their Twitter profile picture and heading to include rainbow imagery, the company has been known to fund anti-LGBTQIA+ politicians. In 2020, they donated over $46,000 to Senator Mitch McConnell's campaign. The trend of corporations changing their branding during Pride Month while doing nothing or actually harming the community on a regular basis has been dubbed rainbow capitalism.
Companies not only celebrate the month, but actively market around it as well. There's a term for that, rainbow capitalism. Walmart and Target have pride-related ads. IKEA has pride-themed love seats.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications.
2022, Balenciaga Teddy Bears. The Kering-owned fashion label is known for making risky choices. However, they crossed a major line in 2022 with two beyond inappropriate series of promotional photos.
So Balenciaga is known for its edgy designs, the brand often pushing the envelope, but critics are accusing the brand now of crossing the line in this latest campaign.
Some of the images show children modeling with bears that are wearing leather harnesses, an unsettling combination. Others from a different campaign include props that deal with disturbing subject matter. Internet sleuths notably spotted a written version of the Supreme Court's opinion in United States v. Williams among papers sprawled on a desk. They also pointed out a book featuring Mikhail Boromins, an artist responsible for producing troubling images of youth. After a few days of silence, Balenciaga brand ambassador Kim Kardashian issued a statement on Twitter saying she was disgusted and outraged.
We sincerely apologize for any offense our holiday campaign may have caused. Our plush bear bags should not have been featured with children in this campaign.
Did you enjoy this video? Check out these other clips from WatchMojo and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.